Hey folks, DC7 here. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to Klino. I'm just getting the forage wagon out here and collecting up a little bit of what's left of the grass. I didn't windrow this batch, so it's a little bit offside, but I thought I'd pick up a bit of it on the way over to where we have actually bothered to windrow. And I will get to windrowing this part later. Alright, here we go. Oops. Not paying any attention. This tractor has a really slow turning. See how slowly it comes back to center? It's kind of funny. You're not picking up any of that. Oh, okay. Well, that's interesting. See how some of this had gotten tethered and some of it hadn't? This only picks up the untethered. That's kind of strange. I've noticed with some forage wagons, they'll do what the balers will do. See, it's not taking any of this. Oh, I didn't pick up all the bales. I thought I did. Yeah, see, it won't pick up any of that, so that's kind of pointless. We need to be picking up the straight grass. And boom, there you go. Immediately starts picking that up. Interesting. Because, yeah, I'm pretty sure the last forage wagon I used was much like the balers. Whatever the last thing you touched is what it turned it into. It was kind of a nice little, well, I'd hesitate to go so far as say cheat, but cheat. Yeah, it was. Yeah, this could definitely use windrowed because, we're getting ick for results. Oh well, do a couple of loops and then I'll take it up to the sheeps. Oh, we're in a little bit different tractor, as you can see. This apparently is a tractor that belonged to their neighbor, and this is a Belarus 82, or an MTC 82 if you wish. But yeah, ooh, this one actually has the fire extinguisher. Cool. I don't remember which one. I have one and it's got the rings there, but there's no fire extinguisher. I thought maybe they couldn't find a model or something. But only thing is, it's odd. I was sure. Let me have a look here. I thought when I bought it that I ordered it with... Oh, front ladder or loader attach. Yeah, it did come with that. I must have just said no. I was going to grab this one, but it won't load. I'm not sure what's going on with that. But, because, yeah, it's also a Belarus MTZ-82. But seeing as I just picked it up from the store, I thought I'd just stay in it and use this to go around the field a time or two. Oh yeah, it's such super slow steering, it's crazy. There we go. So I guess I'll have to use the, well, no, I can use this. I've just got to empty it before I can actually pick up the windrowed stuff. Well, that's all. No big deal. Like I said, I just wanted a little bit of, loose grass for the cows, or the sheep, I should say. But yeah, see, it won't pick up any of this. See, see, see. Bump, 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 bump. I mean, I could ride through these rows. It'll pick up the in-between. See, like, here's a strip. Zoink. Sucks all that up. Actually, that's a good plan, because it'll only leave the other stuff that we actually want, won't it? And again, that sharp turn. There we go. Yeah, Hijinx contacted me again and told me a couple of the bits they'd discovered that had been there. Like, there was a Guildner at one point on the farm. Like I say, this particular tractor, or a very similar model to it. A few things like that, so it really helps. I've also, now that it's been released, picked up the old school John Deere harvester and the odd Russian corn harvester, the pull behind type. Now, I don't think John Deere was used on this farm at all, but I don't know exactly how modern a harvester. So far, it's been mainly info on tractors and such. What they might have used for actual harvesting, I don't know. But I do have the Neva Rostal Mash, whatever the heck it's called there, the older one. And as I said, we've now got the John Deere that we can use in the smaller fields. I don't know that I want to do some of the really big fields with that. I mean, even the Neva, it's going to be a bit of a struggle. So yeah, I don't know that I'd want to do it with the a big field with that John Deere. He's a bumpy field.
Bumpy field.
Well, we're getting a fair bit. We get 60% of a trailer. Getting some of this grass cleaned up. Very nice. Ooh, there's that slow responsiveness. All right. That should probably be enough to keep the sheepies happy for a little bit, anyway. And we got a good 75% of the trailer full. Close enough. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's much more grass to suck out of these piles. There's a little bit on the top, I guess. Yeah, the baler doesn't seem to care. It kind of registers the bale as sort of whatever the either the lion's share of what's in it or just the last thing that went into it as far as that goes. Try and grab a couple of these big clumps. Boom. Blah, blah. There we are. 90%. Let's shut it off. Head out. I don't know if I have traffic on or off. I assume they drive on the proper side of the road in this country, though, seeing as how the signs are arranged. Yeah, not a bad old tractor. Takes her time getting up to speed, then it's scary as heck. Ay, ay, ay. Oh, that's all the gold nuggets. I was trying to figure out what all these dots all over my map, and then I remembered, oh yeah, we found our 10th gold nugget, so now they're everywhere. There we go. That's no, it's a fake. Okay, good. good. Now, hey, Woolies, where would you like this? What the? Oh, I see somebody's camping down there. Just wondering what the heck that truck was doing down there. Hey, buddy, how you doing? There we go.
And that suffices for 6 days.
Of course it does. All right. What's this one telling me? Wool pellets. Ah, okay. So this is where they're going to start producing our wool pellets. Good enough. Good enough. So, oh, look out, buddy. Back down towards the farm. I don't know that I'll give this to the cows. I think I'm going to put it into the bunker. As a matter of fact. And start silaging. Because I've got all those bales for the cows. That's a very simple process, so. I wonder if that's just houses down there, like neighbors type of thing. Interesting. Where the heck am I going? I guess I should go back to the farm. That's the way I wanted to go. I don't have no idea where I'm off to. Just sort of obliviously driving about. Alright, let's get turned around here. Good heavens. So give us a little bit of a look at our field here as well. Which is something I kind of want to do. So I take it that's one of our fields there. Okay. Wow, that's a big sucker. I think we're going to bring the Rostelmash up here. Okay. Oh, I don't know. We'll see. We will see. And this is our other field, I believe. Oh no, this is still, wow. We're just running along the edge of that. Okay. So it's not very wide though, is it? I think we could do that with the John Deere. It'll take us a little bit, maybe.
Maybe.
Yeah. Whoa, nice little frame drop. There we go. Whoa. It takes some getting used to how responsive the other stuff is for this sort of thing. Like I say, this guy, I mean, it turns into it quickly enough, but coming back to center and that sort of thing, no. Of course, I don't imagine it has like power steering or anything like that.
Oh, it's rack and peanut.
Okay, so. Let's get one of these started for silage. We'll do the far one, and then we can get corn silage started in the other one once we actually get to corn. This is straight grass. This isn't chaff. What am I thinking? Indeed. Why was I thinking I could dump grass in there? Uh-oh. Why was I thinking I could drag that trailer up this hill? Here we go. Come on, buddy. Come on. There you go. Huh. Well, I guess we'll see what the rest of it we can tip to our cow friends. And then, I guess we'll have to see what can be done with the rest of it. Boy, this poor little thing has struggles on hills, boy. Not sure what the horsepower. Oh, I guess it's 80 horse or 82 horse. So, not exactly a streaking ton of power, but enough for what we need to do, that's for sure. Now, are they going to take grass here? Apparently. And that's all they're going to take. So, indeed. Got pits all over the place, unfortunately. And, ooh, don't do me much good. Wonder, do I have a spot? Do I even have any such thing where I can store grass? A hayloft? Well, that ain't gonna do it. Futterlogger. This thing holds just about everything. I don't see grass. Yeah, it's no good because the cows are going to walk right through it. Wonder if that's actually going to be anywhere close to sitting on the ground and being usable. Let's try that. There we go. Awesome. And that should allow to simply go around to the other side and pick it up. Alright, good enough. It does indeed. Okay. Not the best solution, maybe, and perhaps we'll come up with something better, like I'll just put a pile somewhere. But that's kind of tucked out of the way. I don't think it's going to spoil things too much for us. And the cows and the sheep have grass. Excellent. We're still a long way from satisfying their actual needs, but we will get there. Yes, we will. Looks good. Looks good. Up. Oh, I don't know if I'll be able to. I can get it around this fuel tank. Whoop. That isn't very good. There we go. Nice. Okay. I've got more bales to pick up. So I do. Alright, down we go. Yeah, I switched over to this trailer because unfortunately this other one, as nice a trailer as it's probably going to be for grains and such. Problem with it is that upper level doesn't really have a proper hitbox on it, and things can go right through it. As I discovered, yeah, I was throwing bales out a mile a minute on my way out through that last one, so not great. Not great. So, but this one works really well, actually, so. Well, that's a great thing. See? Has solid sides. That actually work. Well, I guess I could have brought the wagon back down here, because I'm going to pick up those other ones as... Well, I don't know if that'll work either. I might want to use the forage wagon and come down here with the chaff head on it. That might do it, and pick up these windrows as chaff. Then we can get some silage going. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Can I run with a bale? Ugh. Oh yeah, they're nice and small. Whoa! They do get away on you, though. When you come to a stop, they just keep right on it going. Not an ideal solution. Come. Doo-doo-doo. Yeah, we definitely got to get some field work done, get some crops going on. Well, that worked. I don't know why. Oh, let's drive down there a little further, shall we? Like they say, work smarter, not harder. Yeah, see, even when these flop around and do that sort of thing, they don't fall out of the trailer, which unfortunately they were doing with that last one. If one that was like that one and then fell up against the side, as that one has, yeah, it would basically not stop. It also made it a little more difficult to load because you'd often drop them too close to the inside wall and they just fall right out again. There we go. That wasn't too painful at all. No, I'll just take this one with me in the cab. And back up the hill you go. Hey, piggies! Oh, it's a bouncy wee tractor. Oh, look out! Yeah! He's fine. That's funny. In a really sad sort of way. Which opens the door? There we go. As you can see, it doesn't actually unload them. But that's okay, because we can do that. I don't actually mind this hand system at all. Is that we can just come down here with our little mixer thing and add what we need to add. But of course I'm going to need some straw bales and such as well, which we'll get to. And last bale. There we go. There we are, beautiful. And let's close the back. Boom. All right. That's the grass bales. Nice. Alright, well I've got a bunch of windrowing to do, apparently. So I think I'm going to get on with that. I've got the fence sitting out there all ready to go. There we are, we made good use of that little Belarus. Okay. And I think with that, guys, I'm going to call it an episode. Hope you all enjoyed. If you did, of course, hit the like button. And let me know what you think down in the comments. If there's something you'd like to see, piece of kit we should be looking at, anything like that, you guys know the drill. But till next time, this has been Species 7 for Farm Sims 17. Take care of each other, folks. And ciao for now.